Namaskar. First, I apologize to you for starting the meeting not at 18 hours, as announced in the newspapers, but a little earlier, because our distinguished guest and speaker, he has to go to Chennai this very evening on a very important mission. Very important mission, connected with one of the greatest events that will happen in India. Friends, he is going to speak on the crisis. India is in crisis, and what shall we do to save the nation? ₹1 lakh crores have been withdrawn by foreign investors from India in the last 3 months, March, April and May. The value of the rupee has fallen to over ₹56 to a dollar and is on the way to go down to 60 to 70 rupees. Foreign companies are wanting to exit India because very immorally, retrospectively, some laws are to be applied for those investors who have been invited into India. The current account balance, that is, the excess of imports over exports, has come to 4% of the GDP, about 90,000 crores of rupees is the deficit in the foreign exchange. India's credit rating is downgraded to speculative grade. It is a speculative grade. Nobody can have any more trust in the rupee. And the Standard & Poor's says, that's very, very important what it says, the division of roles between Prime Minister Manmohan Singh and the UPA chairperson Sonia Gandhi has led to weakening of the framework for making economic policy. The paramount political power rests with the leader of the Congress party, who is silent and not seen anywhere, who holds no cabinet position, while the government is led by an unelected Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, who lacks a political base of his own. Standard & Poor's titles his report, "Will India be the first BRIC country to fall?" Brazil, Russia, India, and China, these are called the BRIC countries. So these are supposed to lift the economy of the world up, but will India be the first to fall? The finance minister says that all black money is not black. What is stored in the foreign banks is not black. We have given enough time to be converted into white so that it can finance us. So that is another crisis point. In order to appease resident non-Indians, RNIs, not NRIs, Vande Mataram has been removed from the textbooks in Andhra Pradesh. Government of Andhra Pradesh has been prevailed upon by the RNIs to appeal to the Supreme Court against the judgment that the Andhra Pradesh High Court has given, holding 4.5 reservation for Muslims on the basis of their religion as unconstitutional. They appealed, and the wise Supreme Court has said, no, this constitution does not allow this one. In execution of the Justice Satcher Committee report on Muslim backwardness and alleged discrimination against them, which is actually a rehash of the Peer Poor report of 1938, produced by the Muslim League against the Congress's Hinduization of India, Justice Satcher's report is that one. Every police station must have at least one Muslim policeman. That is the order of Mauni Manmohan Singh ji. In a repeat performance of Bhajan Lal, who sold the entire Janata Legislature Party of Haryana to Indira Congress in 1980, in our own state, previously votes were being sold. MLAs are sold, MPs are sold, now parties are sold. The entire party in Andhra Pradesh has been sold away for a pittance of a Rajya Sabha seat. It was the minister of the Congress-led UPA, Mr. Moily, who started the signatures that Jagan should be made the chief minister. Since Jagan did not say, "Ni Banchanu, Ni Kal Mukta," because he did not say that one, he is now set upon by every type of investigative agency. The High Command declared zero tolerance to corruption. 100,000 crores of rupees have been collected in this state. 80% of them, that is 80,000 crores, have been sent to Delhi. If only Jagan is free, he would let us know, with the cooperation of the CBI, who were the persons who have received that 80,000 crores. But the Sphinx is silent. If only she declares what her assets are and her relatives' assets are. The Indian company law wants that every director of a company should declare who are their relatives, up to your son-in-law, father-in-law, mother-in-law, brother-in-law, sister-in-law, that-in-law, etc. And if the fourth wealthiest person in the world, she is the fourth wealthiest person in the world, one of the 10 most powerful politicians in the world, if she cannot remove corruption, there is no way corruption can be removed in this country. The advisors of the High Command are all resident non-Indians. Andhra Pradesh is very, very familiar. Who comes on behalf of the High Command, not High Command, but High Command, and tells who should do what? If these are not crisis points, what else can be the crisis? And who is more fit to talk about this than this great person, Dr. Subramanian Swamy? His role in the emergency is very well known. I need not have to introduce. One-man army which stopped the UPA government from destroying the great heritage of Ramasetu. It was only he, not any political party. That is what he is. Because of his patriotism and nationalism, the Harvard University does not want him to give lectures. But he need not worry. A person like Bertrand Russell was prevented from speaking in the New York State University because he wrote a book, Why I Am Not a Christian. Bertrand Russell wrote a book, Why I Am Not a Christian. Because he wrote that book, the Christian organizations in the United States prevented him from talking in the New York State University. So such is the person that we have. When people are selling their parties, he stands by Janata. He is one-man army of India, the nationalist patriotic army of India. Give him a cheer, Dr. Subramanian Swamy. And who is presiding over this meeting? Mr. K. Padmanabhai Garu. He was a great secretary in the government of Maharashtra in way back, afterwards in the government of India. The most illustrious thing that he did as the secretary of the Home Ministry and later on was to be the interlocutor of the government of India to deal with the Nagas. There are three interlocutors on behalf of the government of India, some three non-entities who went to J&K and produced the most infamous report saying that this constitution, Article 370, should no longer be called temporary but special one. That means India shall make way for the secessionists. Whereas K. Padmanabhaya, who has been honored with the Padma Bhushan by the President of India, he was the interlocutor for the government of India with the Nagas, who are waging a long-drawn struggle for secession from India, incited by the missionaries. And unlike the three Trimurtis of the government of India's interlocutors in Kashmir, Padmanabhaya very successfully, very wisely, very deftly dealt with the Nagas and brought them into the mainstream. That is what Padmanabhaya is. I am greatly indebted to him for presiding over this meeting. I only hope great patriots like him, who have served the government of India, would now come and see that the peril in which India is placed is not taking place actually. We have to have a Rashtra, a nation. Are we a nation or not? Or is it a conglomeration of nationalities? These are the things which think tanks like the Prajna Bharati and the social cause have been debating and asking, inviting the people to deliberate upon them. I am particularly happy today because the audience is not old people. So far, many of our meetings, only old people were coming. Now at least middle-aged people are coming and young people are also coming. Sir, that's a great hope for India. And if you speak that this is a Hindu state, just as Great Britain is a Christian country, this is a Hindu country, and Hindus have always been secular, always been non-aggressive, etc. This is the need of the hour. So-called secularism is not going to save this country, it is going to destroy this country. So today we are going to have a great treat. I now request Padma Bhushan Sri K. Padmanabhaya Garu to kindly give his opening remarks. Namaskar.